I'm Ted Keyes in Pasadena, California. Welcome to my Tuesday conference call, a free high-powered meeting I hold live every Tuesday for top producing freight agents. Go to tedkeysonline.com for complete call information. Then join us weekly to see new, serious, struggling, and experienced sales professionals move more freight efficiently, effectively, effortlessly, and make more money financially. So watch my recorded call topic highlighted there on your screen right now. When you're finished, go to tedkeysonline.com and hear more podcasts, read more blog posts, watch more videos, and while you're there, visit my Freight Sales Success Store for top-notch freight moving products to explode your business today. Enjoy watching and applying my Tuesday conference call.
Hello and welcome to my Tuesday conference call, everybody. Ted Keyes, your host, your top freight agent training expert here in Southern California. This is a free high-powered meeting I hold live every Tuesday for top producing freight agents at 2 p.m. Pacific time and 5 p.m. Eastern time. On the call today, I'll show you how to move more freight efficiently, effectively, and effortlessly so you make more money financially. And after the call today, go to my website, tedkeysonline.com, to hear more of my podcasts, read more of my blog posts, watch more of my videos. And while you're there taking in all this free information, go to my Freight Sales Success Store for top-notch freight moving products to explode your business today. When you arrive at my Freight Sales Success Store, you'll see a host of products available there for purchase. First one you'll see there is my flagship product, my Freight Sales Success Guide, typically for beginner and struggling freight agents. Also, you'll see my Freight Sales Success Quotes. This is motivation that'll get you on the phone, connecting, collaborating, and building relationships with the marketplace daily. You'll also see my Freight Sales Success Skills. You're going to find out as you become more and more successful in this profession that it's going to require a host of many different skills to assist you in your success. You'll also see my Freight Sales Success Training. This is a product of 17 videos that will basically take you from knowing little or nothing at all about moving freight to watching all the videos one by one and covering your first load and beyond. All these products available right now for sale at my Freight Sales Success Store. And while you're there taking in all this free information, on any one of my website pages off to the right, go ahead and enter your contact details. By doing that, you'll receive your weekly email invite to this and every call. You'll also receive the free attachments that I provide on each and every call. In addition to that, you'll also get a freebie from me, another freebie, and that is my free report, 11 Ways Freight Agents Will and Do Increase Their Income. Got to get the report first, though, to make this happen. And again, my free report has been downloaded thousands of times before. And if you have any questions for me today, or more specifically, are you ready to join our top producing freight sales team? There is a reason why you got on this call today. It's because you see value in what I and my guest will provide today. But if you're ready to join, if and when you're ready to join our top producing freight sales team, then give me a call, Ted Keyes. I'm at 626-309-9141. Today, I have a great guest on the call today. He is my friend, freight carrier expert. He is my freight carrier expert guest, Chris David Martinez of Tucson, Arizona. Are you there, Chris?
Yes, sir, Mr. Keyes. Thank you for that introduction.
Awesome. Welcome to the call today, Chris.
Thank you.
Also, thank you for getting on the call today. Chris, just to clarify real quickly, you have been a truck driver for how long?
I've been a truck driver for 26 years.
Let me just go ahead and ask you a few questions. How did you become a truck driver?
Moving furniture as a kid in Los Angeles, California, for a company out of Hollister, California, up and down I-5. I was 18 years old, so I was able to do a commercial truck without leaving the state.
Okay. Now, was this your truck, Chris, or were you working for somebody?
I was working for an owner.
Okay.
A North American Airlines owner. Not an agent, but an owner.
Okay. And you're from the Southern California area originally?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Orange County. Anaheim.
Orange County.
Anaheim.
Okay. Anaheim, California. Know exactly where it is. So what prompted you to stay in the industry? I mean, there had to have been a time where you moved from doing the heavy lifting to actually doing the driving.
I see a ton of money, to be truthful with you. In the household, it was extremely lucrative in the household industry.
Right.
And even in the freight industry, people are having problems with some of the rates. I'm learning to survive with these rates, and those rates are sort of a cleaning house of sorts. Get rid of all the riffraff, the other drivers, and bring the rates back up.
But what prompted you to get into driving, Chris? Were you answering my question there?
Probably my age. My age got me. I was mostly a mover, doing household, and then I had to drive the freight or the household, you know, up and down the Bay Area, from Bay Area to L.A. And then, are you talking about getting into driving freight?
Yeah, how'd you initially get into driving?
I just saw it being lucrative, and I see it being a career.
Okay.
I never saw it as being some sort of a summer job or even a stepping stone job.
Was that, say, in your early 20s?
Yes, sir. 18 years old.
Who did you start driving with, Chris?
North American Van Lines out of Hollister, California.
Okay. I was under the impression you were just doing the heavy lifting for them. So basically, you went from a lifter to a driver with the same company.
Yes, sir.
Okay. How long did you stay with North American Van Lines?
10 years.
Okay. All right. And was it at 10 years where you basically went from moving into standard freight?
Yeah, I went into standard freight in 01. Injuries, back, ages, you know, you can only do that lifting for so many years.
that's right. You just reminded me, Chris, when you're a driver for a moving company, not only are you driving, but you're also doing the moving as well.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes,
I gotcha. Okay. So basically after 10 years, that prompted you to go from moving into solely driving.
Right. Freight.
What company did you start with when you were, solely working as a driver?
I started out of Fontana, California for a company I know you're familiar with called Dick Simon Trucking.
Dick Simon. Now, they're no longer in business, correct?
Correct. Central Refrigerated bought them out.
Yes, Dick Simon. They had the skunk on the side of their reefers, correct?
And yes, sir. And then his son Kelly started his company here recently called Kelly Transport Services, KTS.
Exactly. Yep. So it sounds like you've, as far as your driving experience is concerned, you have done reefers and dry freight.
Correct.
Okay. All right. Who are you currently driving for, Chris?
Titan. But I'm doing it under my own authority, under my boss's own authority. We've got a Titan trailer, but we're doing it under a separate authority.
Okay.
We're doing it as a contractor.
Okay. Let me ask you this, Chris. Do you have much contact with freight agents and brokers?
I did as a driver, as a company driver. Right now, in this position, I do not, no.
Okay. Well, let's go back to when you were a company driver, Chris.
Yes, sir.
I mean, were you basically talking to agents and brokers every load you did, or were you mainly being dispatched by your company?
Basically, what would happen is we have a Qualcomm. If it was a company load, we'd get the load information, the origin and destination. We'd execute that dispatch. Every, like, twice a week or maybe even once a week, we'd get a phone number to call a broker.
Mm-hmm.
A 1-800 number. Call the broker for load info. Give them this pickup number. So we get your pickup number. And sometimes, as soon as the rate con was given to my company, the broker would already be on the phone with me, calling my phone number. Yeah, so Either they would call me first, or I would know to call them, and it was usually about once or twice a week.
Got it. Got it. Okay. As far as dealing with brokers, I mean, so it sounds like your time dealing with them was more intermittent than anything, Chris.
Intermittent, about equally half as intermittent.
Half and half, 50-50?
Oh, definitely. And then there was a company I was just with last year that it was more broker loads than direct loads.
Okay.
It was all outbound, direct, and inbound brokers. So it was more than 50%.
Okay. But it sounds like you have your experience dealing. And when I say brokers, I'm talking brokers, but more specifically the agent that has those specific loads that you did.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes, sir. I was dealing with mostly the bigger outfits, like TQL or C.H. Robinson. I would be dealing with a freight agent.
Okay. Let me ask you this, Chris. What did agents do that made your job and your profession a delight to be doing?
Oh, they were very professional, which is what I like. They were very, like, the information they conveyed to me was usually very detailed and exactly what I needed. I never had to return a phone call to them regarding, hey, you forgot to give me this number or that number or this address. No. They were always well-trained, unbelievable. I was like, how did you learn this, college? No. Well, yeah, they were very detailed in the information I received. The times were very easy. The pickup and delivery times were within reason.
Mm-hmm.
I was never pressed, and that was a delight for me. I got that a lot more than I didn't. And it was here recently, within the laws, the compliancy laws and everything, they did start giving us more and more reasonable times. If there was lumpers needed, they would convey that. You're going to need to call us about 3 in the morning when I'm delivering at the grocery warehouse. You're going to need to call us. Feel free to call this phone number after hours. Okay. They always took care of me with information. They flooded me with information.
So it sounds like the good agents, the good brokers, were very informative as far as picking up, dropping off, things along that nature.
And reasonable with booking appointments. Yes.
Okay. All right. At the time, you know, in the past, did most of your loads require pickup or delivery appointments?
Yes, sir. In the past, more so than in the present. In the past, you couldn't deliver or pick up anywhere without an appointment. And if you were late, you paid an appointment fee.
Right. Right. Of course, you were doing loads for larger companies if they required a pickup or delivery appointment.
Yep. And refrigerated, 9 out of 10 times, has more. It's a grocery-oriented stuff, refrigerated
mm-hmm.
produce. So, yeah, all those coolers are appointment-only. Most refrigerated coolers are appointment-only on the delivery. On the pickup, not so much.
Okay. So let me ask you this, Chris. As a truck driver that's been on the road now for a number of years, what made your job challenging dealing with agents and brokers?
My challenge with brokers was, and it wasn't even a challenge, I understand it, it's their phone call, their inbound phone call to me, sometimes can be 2 or 3 times a day. Now I believe they have the macro point tracking on mm-hmm. the smartphone. I don't mind that. Some drivers will mind that. I don't mind the macro point tracking. But back in the day, my only challenge was the... call every 3 hours, where are you at? But I moved beyond that. I understand that they have to track that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, let's put it this way. Here's a good guide to go with. Typically, if somebody's tracking you every 3 hours, it's because that agent or that broker has a lot at stake in the load.
Oh, yes, sir.
Does that make sense?
Yes, sir. It's usually a high-value load, and that is understandable. I grew and evolved and matured in the freight business. I don't have any problems with that tracking at all. Matter of fact, I invite it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll call them. I'll call them every 3 hours now.
mm-hmm.
Bug them. Yep.
Okay. All right. So if you were going to give advice to our listening audience here, Chris, and you know we have a listening audience here, and to anyone that will listen to this podcast or watch the video that I'll create from this, What advice will you give to our listening audience, this audience of some of them have moved some loads before, some of them have never moved loads before? What great advice can you give them, Chris?
The great advice I can give a freight agent or broker in communicating with a driver would be detail-oriented. That's it. I mean, detail. I'm talking about origin information. I'm talking about destination information. I'm talking about if there's lumpers needed. I don't know if they have knowledge of that or not, but some of the freight agents I've dealt with, they do know if there's going to be a lumper needed. That way, if I'm at my company, and see, not all brokers will give an express code for a comp check. I have to be able to notify somebody at my company, hey, I got to wake you up at 1 in the morning. You're going to answer your phone or I'm not going to be able to get the bill of lading because they want a lumper check. So that's one of the most important parts is knowledge of accessorials, destination stuff.
Explain to our listening audience, Chris, what is a lumper?
A lumper is an unload service. The DOT or FCC or ICC regulations require that the trucking company is responsible to get the freight off the truck onto the dock. That is the trucking company's responsibility. It's called tailgating. The receiver will often have on premises a lumper service. There's a number of them. The truck driver used to have to hire a guy out of the street to break down his pallets. You have to break down these skids. They go in storage, and they've got to be a certain dimension, 5 high, 10 high, this wide, that high. You got to separate the products. A lumper service separates the products called breaking down a load. Sorts and segregates. You have to pay them. It's usually in the $200 range, and it's usually mostly in grocery warehouses. Grocery warehouses, especially Walmarts.
Absolutely. So that's a good warning. If you have a desire to deal with lumpers, Chris, then call food companies.
Right. Pretty much. Yeah. I mean, there's you can't rely on one as a truck, as a driver, as a company. You have to pepper your customers with. There's all sorts. There's not only grocery warehouses. There's bulk freight, which means there's no lumpers on bulk freight. But you've got to do everything as a truck. You've got to do everything as an agent, I guess. I don't know, maybe they specialize in certain customers, right?
Absolutely, Chris.
Okay.
Absolutely, absolutely. But you made a good point there. Lumpers typically are hired to unload a lot of grocery, not only grocery, but also frozen freight.
Yep.
In these huge freezer companies, they have lumpers as well. And as you said, Chris, lumper is a company that's hired. It's hired by that particular receiver to basically do the unloading and the breaking down of pallets and putting the pallets where they belong inside the warehouse.
Mm-hmm.
Again, it's typically for larger, multi-million, some billion-dollar companies. Typically, in the food business, will use lumpers.
Mm-hmm. And knowledge of that as a driver, knowledge of hey, there's going to be a broker or a lumper needed on the unload. As a freight agent, conveying that to the driver is a world of you don't understand. We won't be able to leave that we won't get our bill of lading until 7 a.m. the next day. If we're unloading at 3 a.m., we won't be able to leave those premises until 7 a.m. when our shop opens up. And if it's a weekend and we don't have knowledge, nobody's going to answer that phone at the company, if it's a smaller trucking company. No one's going to be able to issue a comp check or express code till Monday.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Got it.
We got to have knowledge of everything going on at the receipt.
Hey, Chris, if I could just reiterate, it sounds to me that if you're giving advice to a new freight agent, new freight broker, and they're dispatching you to have all the correct, all the required information to relay that to you so you get the load picked up, get the load in motion, and get the load delivered.
Yes, sir.
That's what it sounds like you're telling me.
Yeah.
Now, does it matter to you? If if the agent treats you with respect or with patience?
They always do anyway. I've never had an impatient freight agent or broker ever. I've never had an angry or upset one. I've never had that experience as a driver.
Yeah. Typically how it works is the smaller trucking companies, they're limited as far as the drivers they hire. A lot of the drivers are beginner drivers, and you'd be surprised, Chris, at how many times we will, you know, as a broker or an agent, use a small trucking company, and, you know, we'll call the driver three times, and he'll never answer the phone.
Oh, yes. That was where I was talking about. That's how I evolved. I realized how the driver will see the number on the phone, and they won't answer it on purpose. They feel, or what I used to feel is, well, hey, you're dealing with Dick Simon Trucking. Why don't you call them? They've got a computer on my truck. They can tell you exactly where I'm at. Mm-hmm. That's a lot of what I heard of drivers say. I don't want to talk to that broker. I got in this truck to deal with dispatch, not brokers. But a lot of these bigger, even smaller companies are using brokers. They will not enter the load on the Qualcomm. They won't enter the load on the computer. They'll just be lazy. They'll get the rate cons. They call the broker. Bam, they pass it on. They don't have to enter any load info at all.
Yeah. So would you say that's more of a lazy attitude, Chris, when drivers don't answer their phone?
It's not lazy. It's they don't want to deal with it. Now, believe me, the driver's not lazy. Some are, but they basically don't feel that it's their job to deal with, especially the bigger companies. They don't feel they don't need to communicate with this broker. Why is the broker calling me? Why do I have to call them? Why aren't you calling my dispatcher? And why aren't they telling me? Because they're used to dealing with a computer, a Qualcomm computer in the truck.
So really, I'm basically getting into this for any drivers that are out there listening to this. One of the most frustrating things that an agent or a broker witnesses is when we call drivers, even though the dispatcher gives us the name and number of the driver, we call the driver to get them going, and voila, they won't answer the phone.
Or to track them, just to get their location.
Well, I'm just talking about in the most general of senses, where there is no tracking technology, where everything is done word of mouth.
Gotcha.
One of the most frustrating things for an agent is calling drivers and they don't answer the phone. So that's just some general information. Again, this has to be a give and take relationship. Would you agree, Chris?
Yes, sir. Yes,
I mean,
sir.
I agree
with you on the phone thing too.
Absolutely. One of the most frustrating things that us agents and brokers witness is, you know, certainly when our shippers, don't want to talk to us, that's understandable. But, you know, hey, we're calling the driver to get them in motion, and they don't answer the phone. How frustrating can that be? You only got 30 minutes to travel 30 miles to get this load picked up. It's 2:30 in the afternoon. It's got to be picked up by 3. We call the driver. Voila, they're not answering the phone. How frustrating do you think that is?
So I understand completely.
It's a give-and-take situation. Chris, what other words of advice, again, can you give a beginner or, you know, just starting off agent or broker in the industry, you know, where it will make their profession better, where they can take the advice and start running with it?
I really don't have anything.
On the transportation side, that is.
On the transportation side, well, all that's pretty much taken care of within a company and the broker. The driver deals with strictly communicating with the broker regarding appointment times and information regarding the pickup and delivery. That's all I can advise them on as far as what the driver deals with. And that's what I've done. I've never had any problem with anything other than knowledge of the accessorials.
Awesome.
Like there's brokers that have, they won't even tell you anything. Here's your address. I got to call them back 3 hours later for a pickup number. I got to call them at 1 a.m. for a broker, for a lumper. And it's like, why didn't you tell me any of this? That's my only complaint, Mr. Keys. And I usually cover it all now when I deal with the broker or freight agent. I make sure to pull that information out of them. So I really don't even have that problem anymore. I've learned from experience what information to get from the agent.
Awesome. Awesome. Chris, are you up for some Q&A from
sure.
our audience?
Yes, sir. I'm up for
awesome.
It.
Awesome. Awesome. So who's got the first question for Chris? Again, we're talking about a truck driver here. As you know, typically I deal with sales presentations, how to connect effectively and productively and successfully with our shipping decision makers in certain areas of our profession. But today we're talking about an actual live guest here who's been a truck driver for over 26 years. Correct, Chris?
Yes, sir.
We're talking about a truck driver that's been doing this. And as you just said, Chris, when you're being dispatched by an agent, by a broker, and I would venture to say that when they start giving you information, you already have an idea of what type of load it is.
Oh, yeah.
So based on that, you know what questions to ask them, or, hey, you know, what's the pickup number? You know, what's the lumper fee when I get this picked up? What's the lumper fee when I get it delivered? You know those questions to ask when they're giving you the information.
Yes, sir. Can I say one more quick thing? A lot of times the broker or the freight agent won't give you the pickup number until you arrive at the origin, and that's okay. All I got to do is call them when I get there at the origin. They want to know what time you're getting there. So they'll hold back on the pickup number. Tell me that. Don't make me walk all the way up front and hit the window, because remember, as a driver, we're waiting in line at that window, and there's usually 10 drivers ahead of us.
Absolutely.
So when once we get to that window, it's nice if they say you got an 8-digit pickup number, starts with an 8.
Mm-hmm.
No, sir. So now I get to call you, and then I get to go stand in line again with 10 drivers deep.
Mm-hmm.
Just if you want me to call you when I get there, tell me that so I can call you when I get there, not when I'm at the window, and then give me the pickup number. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, obtaining all that stuff, sometimes the broker fails too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Chris, at some point, somebody in the listening audience is going to want you to do a load for them.
Okay.
Okay. Do you have an issue with giving your phone number, your contact info, Chris?
No, sir. Matter of fact, I allow macro point. Like I said earlier, I allow all that.
Okay. Okay. So if anybody wants to get a hold of you, Chris, what's your number?
My phone number is 520-268-5368.
One more time?
520-268-5368.
Awesome. Awesome. Another way that somebody can connect with you, Chris, is via Facebook.
Yes, sir. I'm big on the Facebook.
not only connecting personally, but you also have a Facebook group. Is that correct?
Yes. Yes, sir. I do have a Facebook group. The name of that group is Truck Driver Survival. And it's on YouTube, too. The point of that is to...
One more time, Chris. What's the name of your Facebook group?
Truck Driver Survival, all capital letters.
Truck Drivers Survival.
Yep.
For those of you that are interested in connecting with Chris on his Facebook group. And you said you also have a YouTube channel?
Yeah, but it's limited. It's only got 9 or 10 videos on it.
Okay. Hey, 9 or 10 is more than one, but they're videos of high value, correct?
I make them try to educate people, yes.
Okay. Okay, good deal. Any other bit of information? Hang tight here. 1 second here. Any other bit of information, personal information, that you want to share with us before we get into some Q&A? You gave your number, you gave your Facebook group, your YouTube channel. I would venture to say that you allow people to connect with you directly on Facebook. But on Facebook,
sure.
You go under Christopher David Martinez, correct?
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay.
Sir, that's my name.
Okay, Christopher David Martinez. For any of you that want to connect with Chris, on his Facebook page or
mm-hmm.
Facebook group.
Thank you, Mr. Keys.
Chris, are you up for some Q&A?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Who's got the first question for Chris? First question for Chris, hit *6. Hit *6. And again, remember, Chris is a driver. You're not going to do well if you ask him a sales question, but if happens, who's gonna be first hit star six? Who's up first? Chris, while we're getting your first question on the line here, anything else you can think of that you'd like to share with us?
No, Mr. Keys, I love my job so much. I've made it easy because I realize it's already stressful enough in other areas.
Mm-hmm.
Dealing with brokers and freight agents, anything in this job has never really been hard for me. Mm-hmm. Only because I love this job so much. I am Tommy Trucker. I am the road. There are people that don't belong out here that I'm sure your students, your people will deal with that are high stress. They're yelling. I've seen it. I've seen drivers yelling at brokers over the phone, top of their lungs. I'm like, why are you yelling at that broker? It's like, you don't belong out here. You're not having fun. You're not having fun. My job is so fun and so easy. I've made it that way. So I guess I'm 75% of all drivers.
Chris, is there any road that you can think of that you haven't traveled on yet?
Anyone of
major significance? I mean, have you been on every major freeway now?
I've been on every major freeway, yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
I mean, have you been on Highway 50 going through Nevada?
I'm sure you're talking about US 50.
US
I was
50?
Born. I was. Yep, I was raised. Yeah, I've been on that. I was raised
Fallon,
in a town called
Fallon to Ely.
Yes, sir. Fallon is where my brother used to do the rodeo. I was raised in Battle Mountain, Nevada.
Okay, Battle Mountain. Okay, all right. Yeah, I figured I'd throw that one out there because it's called America's Loneliest Road.
Okay.
So.
I've been on it. I've been on it. I've been on an old route that they used to call the Devil's Highway that I'm kind of proud of. It used to be old Route 666. They changed it to the 191 now. You remember the old Route 666?
Northwestern New Mexico.
Yes, sir.
Yep.
Yes, sir. That's my big claim to fame.
Yeah,
I think
unfortunately,
that's
in the Navajo Indian Reservation.
Yep.
And unfortunately, a lot of deaths occurred on that road. Hence, the what was it called? The Devil's Highway.
Yeah, 666.
Got it. Who's got the first question for Chris? It's star six. Anybody up on deck with a question for him? Anything else you want to share with us, Chris? Any other road that you can think of that you haven't been down?
No, sir. I'm very grateful for this. I'm very grateful for this interview. I've shared as much as I can share that I know to share.
Okay. Does anybody have a question for Chris today?
I do.
Fire away. Who's speaking?
Tony.
Did you say Tony?
Yes, I did.
Tony, okay. Tony, what questions do you have for Chris today?
I want to ask him from a truck driver's perspective, how do you come up with an acceptable rate when someone offers you a load?
Well, you got to remember, I'm speaking from a company driver perspective. I'm already paid a base rate from the company. As a owner-operator, I haven't dealt with many
negotiations.
Yes, exactly. A company driver never negotiates, so I haven't done much broker negotiations.
Yeah. Yeah. Tony, Chris is mainly, 95% of what you have done so far is as a company driver.
Yes,
correct?
Sir. Yes, sir. Company driver.
Yeah. So basically, you're given instructions on where to pick up, where to drop off, when and where, when, you know, what time to pick up, what time to drop off.
Cool.
Correct, Chris?
Yes, sir. Okay. I do not. I'm paid the same no matter loaded or empty.
Got it. Okay. Unfortunately, did you? I mean, he's not an owner operator, Tony. Do you have another question for him while you're still there?
No, that's all I can think of.
Are you an owner operator, Tony?
No, I'm an agent.
Oh, you're an agent. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Great question, Tony.
Thank you.
Who's got the next question for Chris? Next question for Chris. Next question for Chris. We got a live, real live driver on the line. This is something. something that you folks will be dealing with constantly. Dealing constantly with drivers is part of our profession, part of our business, part of that group that we connect and collaborate with as well. However, dealing with guys like you, Chris, only comes after we've connected with the customer first.
Yes, sir.
I must throw that in there. If we don't learn how to connect with the customer first, we will unfortunately not deal with any truck drivers. We got to learn how to connect and build relationships first. Next question for Chris. Who's got it? Hit star six. Chris, anything else you want to add before we break for today?
No, sir. I'm very happy that these people have chosen to be freight agents, and I know they're going to be patient and understanding and dealing with drivers.
Okay, awesome. If we don't have any more questions for Chris, I'll give you folks one more opportunity to ask. Okay.
I think I have a question.
Fire away. Who's that?
All right, this is Dominic.
Dominic.
Hi, Dominic.
Hey, how you doing, Chris?
Outstanding.
So I heard you mention earlier that there's times where sometimes the agent needs to get on the phone with you all hours of the night, like you were saying, 3 o'clock in the morning. In this industry, I guess for agents and brokers, does that happen often? Are agents constantly going to be on the phone, like, all hours of the night?
No. Agents are usually respectful of business hours. What I mentioned there was the driver will sometimes need an after-hours number to call because he was unaware. The driver's never aware of the cost of the broker or the cost of the lumper. I'm sorry. The driver's never aware of the cost of the lumper. Nobody is. Receivers don't know that yet until they see the bill of lading. There has to be a way to communicate with somebody, or there has to be a knowledge of a lumper in the first place. But you're not going to see a driver calling you at 2 and 3 in the morning, nor are you going to be calling a driver all hours of the night. No.
Dominic, to answer your question, no, that is not the norm at all. We typically operate under normal business hours, start in the morning, wrap it up, you know, mid to late afternoon. Those are our normal business hours, Dominic.
Okay, and what kind of situations would the driver need to get in touch with the agent? Like, what could possibly come up where the driver needs to call the agent or...
Lumper. Know? Lumper. Lumper.
That's it?
Lumper. Yep. That's the only reason.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Well, that's good info.
And as a beginner agent, you won't run into lumpers, Dominic.
Oh.
Okay.
As a beginner. Because typically, as you said, Chris... We're talking about, million and multi-million and billion-dollar companies, okay? Typically, a beginner agent does not start with companies like that. They just don't have the experience. A beginner will start off with smaller companies, you know, that are moving a load here, a load there, or, you know, a smaller number of loads, you know, on a weekly basis. Because those are typically the companies that give a beginner the opportunity to move their freight. But, you know, Walmart, you have no business calling Walmart if you've never moved a load before. Or Safeway or Vons. I mean, you have to have tremendous experience before you move a type of load like that. Make sense? Guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next question for Chris. All right. Hey, Chris, been a true delight having you on here. Thank you so much for getting on and answering my questions and certainly the questions of our listening audience. Anything to say before we wrap this up?
No, sir. Just thank you for having me as a guest.
Okay.
I appreciate it.
Awesome. Chris, we'll be praying for you on our end.
Thank you.
That you remain safe and maintain that sound mind and certainly that great attitude that you have.
What a great attitude
that you have, Chris, because you are definitely not the norm when it comes to drivers.
Thank you.
Okay, awesome. Just in wrapping up today, guys, I'll say it again. Do you have any questions? Any questions in particular specifically for me that we talked about during the call today? Or more specifically, are you ready to join our top producing freight sales team? Then give me a call. Ted Keyes, I'm at 626-309-9141. Next question I have is, do you want to receive, again, this is on my normal calls that I do, do you want to receive those free attachments that I provide on each and every call that I specifically explain on the topic that I'm talking about? Then go to my website, tedkeysonline.com, and on any one of my website pages off to the right, just enter your contact details. Thank you so much for joining me today and Chris on my Tuesday conference call. It's been a pleasure. We'll hear you all again next week, same time, 2 p.m. Pacific time and 5 p.m. Eastern time. Take care, everybody. God bless. We'll see you all again on my Tuesday conference call next week. Bye-bye.
You've just taken a tremendous step forward by watching and applying my Tuesday conference call highlight. Do you desire to earn and learn with our top freight team and Christian-based office? Yes, we're searching for a self-starter who's serious, motivated, and ready to take action right now. Is that you? Go to tedkeysonline.com/contacts and enter your contact details. We provide top-notch freight agent sales training to you. Then you deliver those same skills with confidence to the freight industry marketplace. I'll talk to you soon.